All right, so let's start digging in and getting this off and checking out this wastegate, why it's messing up. When your boosted car's not running right, what do? You go out and buy one of these.
If they hatin', got a price to pay. California on my license plate. Last year they ain't even like the bay. Damn, but we don't never trip. All I know is gas break dip. No, we never trick on that bitch. No, I can't quit. No, I don't fuck with that mid, bitch. But hey, put me on some. Put me on some, put me on some, put me on some, put me on some. Yeah, we really going down.
All right, so first thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and take the feed line off, take these clamps off, and then the four bolts on the flange, turbo flange, and then I'll go ahead and pull that aside. Oh, fuck. I'll take that clamp off too. God, that thing's a bitch to put on. Whatever, gotta take it off. Alright, first thing I noticed when I took my first hose off that goes right here, it was kind of torn like that and kind of stuck right here, so it kind of ripped. That could be the issue, but I'm just going to do it on the safe side. I'm going to take everything off and just double check that because I don't want to have to go put this hose on and then come to find out, well, I still got to pull this off. And there's no point in driving it and getting it all hot. And I got to wait 2 hours for this to cool down. So let's just take it all off and find out if we can find something there too. All right. All right, so I'll pop the feed line off right now. Can't really tell on the camera, but there is moisture in there. There's some moisture in there too. So that's a good sign. It's getting oil. I did notice when I got done with my tune, the oil pressure connector that's down here was off, so that might have been causing some issues too. But like I said, we're just gonna go ahead and pull the wastegate off and double check everything. But definitely getting oil to the turbo. All right, let me go ahead and stop here. Let me go ahead and finish and get this thing off. That way I can start crunching on this. All right, so the turbo's pretty much off the exhaust manifold. This line that was here on the bottom, it wasn't on there too strong. I just basically pulled on it and it came off, kinda. This one's on there pretty good, as you can see right now. I'm pulling on it, it's not coming off. This one did, so maybe it was coming from this area. But like I said, I'll go ahead and I'll show you the other fittings I'm gonna run, and we'll see if that works even better. But another thing is too, once I get the wastegate out, I gotta pull these out too and put some liquid Teflon on them, just a little bit on it, just to make sure there's no leaks on there. I didn't do that the first time around. So let me go ahead, let me see if I can actually spin this by hand. Yeah, see, I don't think it's the fire ring or the fucking this flange, because I'm not getting nothing moving on here. So I think it was that hose or the one that was on this right here, this fitting. But anyways, so I'm gonna go ahead and address all this stuff, pull this off, double check the fire ring, and put this back on. And then I gotta put this thing's a bitch to get back on by myself, but I'll manage. I do it every single time. All right, so let me go ahead and pop this wastegate off, and then we'll jump back into this. All right, wastegate is out. So I went ahead and took out the fire ring and was just trying to match it up to here. As far as I can tell, that flange is gonna be all right. There's a little bit of wiggle room, but I don't think that would cause enough to leak. But I think this is okay. It fits in there pretty good. As for all the stuff on the wastegate, I think is gonna be okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the fittings I was using on my old wastegate, hook them up to here, put the Teflon, liquid Teflon on those fittings, and put it back on and pray I get no more cutting out at 6,000 RPMs. So let me go ahead and do it. Oh shit, jump into that and do that. So I jumped ahead. Got the wastegate back on. Went to put a little. I went and put the original ones back on. I honestly, after doing this, this flange right here, the old flange too I had on here was really loose. This one is fucking super tight, and it's clamped really good. So that might have been the issue too. I don't think it was these. Maybe just the one bottom hose might have been too loose. So I'm just gonna go with these fittings. If Tile supplies them, of course they're good fittings. So there must be the hoses. There's something else with it. Anyways, so I got just about got it on. I gotta hook up the hoses on the wastegate. Plug them back in. I gotta go back and look and reference myself on which hose goes where. But it's almost done, and then I'm gonna go ahead and take it for a spin. Alright, everything's hooked up, so let's go take it for a drive. Oh fuck. I forgot to hook these clamps up. Alright, let's fix that real quick. Alright. Clamps are on, let's go ahead and try this again. Hope there's no fucking vacuum leak or boost leak. This just in case. Just in case that clamp comes off. Alright, let's go for a test drive as soon as the bad boy warms up. Alright, so this is next day from the last clip you just seen. We took it out this morning and did some data logging, driving it. We're still having issues with the wastegate. At wide open throttle, when it hits 6,000 RPMs, something's going on with the wastegate where it's not doing what it's supposed to do. Basically kicks out and comes back in again. So I gotta figure out what's going on with the wastegate. The wastegate's brand new Tile wastegate. Let me show you. Basically we were driving, he told me to pull over, disconnect all the lines from the the boost solenoid. Yeah, boost solenoid. And just to hook up off the charge side straight into the wastegate to test the wastegate. I am running an 11-pound spring, so we did that, tested it, and still under wide open throttle, it's cutting out at 6,000. Only 6,000 RPMs, it's backing out and then coming back in. So I'm probably gonna have to take the wastegate off again. And just open it up, check everything inside, check the springs, check the diaphragm, just check everything. I have no idea what to do right now. But if anybody's got any ideas, comment below. As of right now, everything for the tune is where it needs to be. He set it up, some safety parts in it to where if once I get the wastegate apart, put it back on and take it out for test run, that I can open it up and see if it's still doing it, and then keep doing that until I figure out my wastegate issue. So that was cool of him to do that. Other than that, I mean, it's just wastegate issue. That's the only issue I'm having. Everything else is fucking running really good. So maybe what we were thinking, maybe it was gonna be the boost solenoid, but again, we took off the, disconnected the boost solenoid hoses and ran off the charge side into the wastegate, and we're still having wastegate issues. I'm hoping it's not that flange on that exhaust manifold that I gotta fuck with, that maybe it's fucking leaking out of there somehow. Maybe the flanges they ain't matching up or something, but fuck, I don't know. Frustrating. It's like right there, but I just can't get it fucking dialed in because of the wastegate. So yeah, let me go ahead and flip it and show you guys. All right, so like I said, we disconnected all the lines, took the line off here, ran it in to this one right here, and just running off a wastegate spring, and we're still having the cutout issues. So again, I don't know what the fuck. I'm gonna pop this fucking all this shit off again and check the wastegate again. Open her up. Check the diaphragm, check fucking the springs, just double check everything. But Yeah, that's the only issue. So if anybody's got any ideas, drop a comment below. I'm gonna go ahead and post on my Instagram too, see if I can get some help that way, see if somebody can point me in the direction where I need to go. But yeah, it's what it is. We'll get it figured out. I just gotta take it off again, put it back on, take it off while we're getting, put it back on, and just do everything I need to do to make sure that that wastegate is doing what it's supposed to do. So yeah, that's what it is. It is what it is. Like, subscribe, KL Day. Catch you guys on the next one.